This is a very short introduction of committees system. There are other videos concerning committees in this homepage. Please watch them in order to understand the details of committees. This is the outline of this video. I will explain 1. Status of committees in the legislative process. 2. Types of committees. 3. Basic rules of committees. 4. Function of committees. 1. Deliberation of bills. 2. Investigation in relation to government. 5. Real politics behind the scenes. 1. Status of committees in the legislative process. In the Imperial Diet, mainly before the Second World War, the plenary sitting, which is all members' meeting, played a central role in the legislative process. There was the three-reading system of the plenary sitting at that time. Under that system, a bill was deliberated in the first reading of the plenary sitting, and in the middle of the first reading, a bill was referred to special members of a special committee for a specific bill, and after the deliberation of the committee, the bill was returned to the first reading stage of the plenary sitting. Then they decided whether they would proceed to the second reading stage or not. In the second reading stage, they deliberated each article of the bill and they deliberated amendments. In the third reading, they decided whether they would pass the bill as a whole. In real practice, three-reading system was not strictly enforced, but formally that system was maintained. In the Imperial Diet, there were only 5 standing committees. They were the Committee on Budget, Committee on Audit, Committee on Petition, Committee on Discipline, and Committee on Proposal. On the contrary, in the present Diet after the Second World War, the committees are the heart of the legislative process. It is said that the GHQ, General Headquarters, introduced the committee system of the United States Congress into the Japanese Diet. We have 17 standing committees now, and 12 committees have the jurisdictions which correspond to the jurisdictions of cabinet ministries. In the present Diet, the bills which are introduced by the cabinet or members are directly referred to committees in principle, except some important bills which are deliberated in the plenary sitting before the referral to committees. After the committee has passed the bill, it will become the agenda of the plenary sitting, and usually it will be approved. 2. Types of committees. We have 2 types of committees, standing committees and special committees. The standing committees are permanent bodies, and their jurisdictions are described in the rule of the House. We have 17 standing committees now. 12 committees have jurisdictions which correspond to jurisdictions of ministries of the administration. The other 5 committees are Committees on the Fundamental National Policies, Committee on Budget, Committee on Audit and Oversight of Administration, Committee on Rules and Administration, and Committee on Discipline. According to the Diet Law, every Diet member should serve on at least 1 standing committee during his or her term of office in principle. The chairpersons are elected in a plenary sitting. The allocation of the number of committee members to the in-house groups depends on numerical strength of in-house groups. Most committees deal with matters under the jurisdiction of the concerning ministries. The special committees are established by House resolution when they are deemed necessary to examine specific issues or proposed bills. The number, size, and functions of the special committees are determined by the resolution of the House. The members of special committees are nominated by the Speaker, and chairpersons of committees are elected in each committee. Now we have 9 special committees. Special committees are established at the beginning of each Diet session and are abolished before the next Diet session. But some of the special committees, such as the Special Committee on Disasters and the Special Committee on the Election Law, continue to exist almost permanently. 3. Basic rules of committees. The chairpersons of the committees have the right to maintain order of the committees and the right to arrange its business. No business may be transacted and no decision may be taken in a committee unless at least one half of its members are present. It is called a quorum. All matters shall be decided in a committee by a majority of the members present. In the case of a tie, the chairperson shall make a decision. A committee may hold open hearings on important matters of popular concern and for general purposes, and committees may hear views from the interested parties or people of learning and experience. Open hearings must be held on the overall budget and important bills concerning revenue. The Diet Law says that no persons other than members are admitted to a committee meeting as visitors, but this provision does not apply to those engaged in news service or any others who have obtained the permission of the chairperson. In practice, it is safely be said that committees are open to the public. In rare cases, a committee can hold closed meetings if it decides to do so. For the maintenance of order, the chairperson may order any of the visitors to leave the meeting room. 4. Functions of committees. As for functions of the committees, there are 2 main functions. They are deliberation of bills and investigation in relation to the government. 1. Deliberation of bills. Members, committees, and the cabinet can submit bills. Once a bill is submitted, except the bills which committees introduced, they are referred to an appropriate committee. When the Committee on Rules and Administration deems it necessary, explanation of a bill and questions and answers session are held in the plenary sitting before the referral to the committee. Committee deliberations begin with briefing on bill, which is an explanation of the major features of the proposed bill, and then committee has question and answer session. In the question and answer session, committee members ask questions to government ministers and other officials involved in drawing up the bill, or members who submitted the bill. Usually, in a director's meeting, the length of the time and time allocation are decided, considering the numerical strength of in-house groups. Experts may be called to testify, and if necessary, amendments may be deliberated, and there may be discussion. Here, discussion means expression of positions for or against bills. As special forms of deliberation, committees may dispatch committee members to hold a local meeting, hold an open hearing, or have a combined meeting with other committees. After these, voting of the bill is taken. The method of voting in a committee is that those who support the bill stand up and those who oppose the bill keep sitting. Old business is decided by the majority vote of the members present. When necessary, a related resolution is adopted to make a supplementary statement, but is not legally binding. The results of the deliberations are reported to the plenary sitting by the committee chairpersons. Then, final vote is taken in the plenary sitting. 2. Investigation in relation to government. Each house has the right to conduct investigations in relation to government. It is very important to oversee the actions of the administration from the viewpoint of check and balance. Standing committees decide the matters that they will investigate and commence their investigations with the approval of the speaker. Special committees investigate matters that are referred to them. Each committee conducts investigation in various manners, such as dispatch of members to every region of Japan and summon of witnesses. Through investigations, committees identify issues suitable for legislative review, and detailed deliberation of proposed legislation is also made by these committees. 5. Real politics in the deliberation of bills in committees. In Japan, we have parliamentary cabinet system. Prime Minister is usually elected from the members of the majority party in the House of Representatives. The Prime Minister exercises political power with parliamentary confidence. In Japan, many bills which are approved by both houses are those which were introduced by the cabinet. And in Japan, the ruling party deliberates the bills before the cabinet submits the bills to the Diet. The members of the ruling party listen to the explanation of the bills from the executive branch, express their opinions, and finally approve the bills beforehand. So the majority party basically supports the bills which the cabinet has introduced, and in the committees, members of the opposition parties try to point out the problems of the bills. More question time is allocated to opposition party members rather than those of ruling parties. One more characteristic point in Japan is that the party discipline is very strong compared to other countries. So, if the party or in-house group decides the attitude toward the bill, members who belong to the group vote according to the party's decision. Under these political cultures, it tends to be difficult to amend the bills which the cabinet has introduced, and there would be some battles of scheduling about deliberation of bills. Each party has Diet Affairs Committee. It is an informative organization, but the chairpersons of the Diet Affairs Committee negotiate the whole management of the deliberation of the bills behind the scenes. Formally, the directors' meeting decide the schedule of the deliberation of the bills, and in many cases, the leading directors of both sides have negotiations before the directors' meeting, but behind the scenes, there may be some negotiation among the chairpersons of the Diet Affairs Committee regarding important issues. You have to keep in mind that there may be both formal and informal negotiations in real politics, and sometimes it is difficult to see the informal process. This is the end of this video. I hope this will be informative for you to understand the committee system in Japan. Thank you for listening.